Amen. Good morning. A good foretaste of the good music that is to come on this Palm Sunday as we celebrate Jesus' entry into Jerusalem and we are able to enjoy our Cantata. So, great morning to be in worship, and you're all welcome to be here, and those of you who are joining us online. So just a few announcements to get us started. I would remind you about the red books that are in your pews. If you would sign those for your attendance, pass them down your pew, and then pass them back to the side where they came, we can have a better idea of who's here and who's not. You'll see lots of information in your bulletin. Holy Week is upon us, and seems like it was just Ash Wednesday. So check your bulletin for all the special services that are happening this week. Two things to call your attention to, and that is we need reservations today. If you plan to attend the Seder meal on Thursday or the breakfast on Easter morning. So see Darren today if you need to make a reservation. There's information there about the upcoming church directory with the dates for the photographs. So I hope that you will plan to sign up for pictures. On April 7th, during the Sunday school hour, we will have a presentation by Dementia Friends. Dementia is something that affects all of us in one way or another. We all know someone, I believe, who is suffering with dementia. And so it'll be a good informational time for us. So I invite you to either come early or to stay late on April 7th. You'll also see in the bulletin some information about a trip we're gonna take to Franklin to see Jesus Christ Superstar on April 28th. That's a Sunday in the afternoon at the Barrow in Franklin, and we will be eating together at Hoss's in Seneca following that. And we do need to have your reservations by April 21st. Just a reminder that our schedule for next Sunday is our sunrise service at 7, followed by breakfast, and then our combined worship at 9:30. Correction in the bulletin, the ladies' breakfast is at 8 o'clock tomorrow morning at Perkins. And just a reminder that the Easter offering envelopes are in the back of your pew. There's also ways to give online if you're so inclined to give to our Easter offering. So I believe those are the announcements for this morning. As we prepare to worship, if you would join with me for the call to worship. Let us stand together. We come to prepare for the holiest of weeks.
We
Jesus leads us through this week, and we will follow, for he is the life we long for, he is the word who sustains us. We wave palm branches in anticipation, we lay our love before him to cushion his walk. Setting aside all power, glory, and might, he comes, modeling humility and obedience for all of us. Hosanna, Hosanna. Blessed is the one who brings us the kingdom of God.
Thank you.
may be seated, and I would invite the kids to come forward. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you this morning?
Good.
Good. You ready? This is Holy Week. We're starting Holy Week. What's that mean? That's right. We're celebrating the last days of Jesus' life here on earth. On Monday, Thursday with the Last Supper, and then Good Friday, and then next Easter. Okay? Next Sunday. So good to have you here. I'm going to send you downstairs with a prayer. How's that sound? Yes, honey.
Isn't this Friday going to be the day Jesus died?
Absolutely. You're exactly right. This is Good Friday, which really is a hard time. We have a hard time saying it's good, don't we? Because Jesus died. But he died for us. Brady. It's your birthday on Tuesday. You're pretty sure it is. Does anybody else have a birthday this week? We're pretty sure it's Brady's, but we're not positive. Can we sing to you before you leave? Well, we're going to do it anyway. I'm pretty sure we're going to do it. If someone wants to start us up there in the corner. Birthday
to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday dear Brady, happy birthday to you.
Now listen to that. All right, so next Sunday, you let us know if it was your birthday, okay? All right, let's pray. God, it's so good to have these kids with us in worship. It's so good to celebrate them and with them. And we just ask, God, that you would be with them as they too travel through Holy Week, that they can find the special meaning of what it is that your Son, Jesus Christ, did for us. And so I just pray for your blessing to be upon them, that you would keep them safe and healthy and in your care. And we pray for all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, you're free to go downstairs. So we gather for worship, we gather to praise God, and we gather as the body of Christ to share our joys and our concerns. So what joys do you have? Mary, you're back in church. We're glad you and Willie are feeling better. So that's a joy. Yes. Oh, wow. All right. So happy birthday to your mom and safe travels for you. Others. It was a joy for me on Thursday to travel with our confirmands and some of their parents to the conference event. I think they learned a lot, and you can be proud of them. They were very polite and well-mannered, and I was very proud of them. So I'm looking forward to working with them. Any other joys? All right, a few concerns this morning. Andrew Womeldorf is our care person, so I'd ask that you'd remember him in prayer or with a card. Lee Mortland, who was a member of this congregation, passed away this past week, so we need to keep his family in prayer. And as always, we are praying for Eliza and Tony Kopp. So let's come together in prayer. We pray to you, Lord of palm branches and the cross. We come before you with joys and celebrations. We're thankful, God, for everyone who is here this morning. We're thankful for those who are feeling better. We're grateful for birthday celebrations and the ability to be with those we love as they celebrate milestone birthdays. And we're thankful for the choir and for those who are guest performers for us today. And we're just thankful for their hard work that they have put into their cantata. And we just pray, God, that they will be blessed in presenting it as we will be blessed in hearing it. God, we pray for your church, that all those who trust in Jesus will be made able by your Spirit to follow his humility, to see and imitate his servant life, to welcome and not to condemn. God, help this church to be like Jesus. God, we ask that you will rearrange our priorities and help us to live more like Jesus, because we know that just as there were the palm branches on Sunday and the crosses by Friday, you know how quickly life changes to death. And we pray for those who have recently lost those whom they have loved. We pray that you would be with them in the pain and sorrow. We pray for hearts to be open to the comfort of your Spirit, shown through friendship and community. We remember those who are struggling in these days with pain and suffering, of lack of trust and hope, and we name them before you now. We just pray, God, that you would surround Andrew with your love and concern, that he would know that our thoughts and prayers are with them. We certainly thank you for the life of Lee Mortland and pray that you would be with his family in this time of grief. And we pray for Liza and Tony, that you would just help them to get through the demands of each and every day. We ask, God of grace, that you will make us more like some of the crowd, that we will follow Jesus and give him our praise in the way that we live, that we will turn away from wrong and evil and stand on the Master's side. We pray that we'll be faithful in worshiping the one who has come in the Lord's name, through our singing, our worship, our prayers, our attention, in the giving of our skills and time and means through all the days of our lives. Bless us, we pray. Bless that all that we do is given to your glory and the good of your creation. We pray now, coming together as Jesus taught us, to pray using the words that he used. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. This time I would like to ask the ushers to come forward to receive our tithes and offerings.
Thank you.
gracious God, we give you our thanks and praise. It's with gratitude that we bring forth these offerings, the work of our hands, for the work of your church. So we ask, God, that you would help us to be good stewards, that you would help us to know and discern what it is that we need to do for the good of your church, for the good of your creation, as we seek to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. We thank you, God, for the privilege of being your church. We pray for your blessing upon each gift and each giver. In Jesus' name, amen. So this morning we turn to the Gospel of Luke, chapter 19, verses 28 to 38, to hear Luke's account of that Palm Sunday, as people desperately came to Jerusalem seeking Jesus as their king. After Jesus had said this, he went on ahead going up to Jerusalem. As he approached Bethpage and Bethany at the hill called the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples, saying to them, "Go to the village ahead of you, and as you enter it, you will find a colt tied there, which no one has ever ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you, 'Why are you untying it?' say, 'The Lord needs it.'" Those who were sent ahead went and found it just as he had told them. As they were untying the colt, its owners asked them, "Why are you untying the colt?" And they replied, "The Lord needs it." They brought it to Jesus, threw their cloaks on the colt, and put Jesus on it. As he went along, people spread their cloaks on the road. When he came near the place where the road goes down the Mount of Olives, the whole crowd of disciples began joyfully to praise God in loud voices for all the miracles they had seen. Blessed is the King who comes, all the miracles they had seen. Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Good morning, everybody. This Easter season, I chose for the choir to present a piece called Requiem. I want to introduce a few people who are soloists, but I'd like to begin with telling you What a wonderful time it was working with our choir and their diligent preparation for this piece. In piece number two, we have a cellist, Rebecca Simmons, and we have a special thing from her. She's helping us sing the piece, which is wonderful too. A person who has been with us multiple times over the past years is our soprano soloist, Dana Soliday, and another friend of our choir, who has presented many things for us over the years, is Brent Register. Now, I will say this. I was remiss in the first service. There is one person who helps this choir so much, and we greatly appreciate our wonderful accompanist, Mary Brooks. So. We will end with the Requiem, and then that is the benediction also. Okay?
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.